of nails that was tied to it. And each time that they were hit him with the whip, it gets stuck into the flesh, and they want to snatch it back out to lash him again. And when they snatched it out, it broke out flesh, skin, blood. It just tore him open. The Bible said, he did not say a murmuring word.
My God.
He just hung there. And he took it. And he looked up into heaven. And he said, Lord, don't hold this sin against them. Because they know not what they're doing. They don't really know that I'm the Son of God. They don't know that I'm God. I told them, Lord, but they still don't know. Because if they knew, they would not do this. Don't hold it to their account, but put it on my account. Put it with that same sin that I'm dying for. That same sin that's on my shoulder right now, covered under the blood. As he died, the Bible says that he said that it is finished. Father, you got what you wanted.
Yes, it is.
Your relationship with man,
yes,
is restored.
Yes.
Then he hung his head down in the locks of his shoulder. And with a scream, he gave up the ghost. He said, Father, I send my spirit unto you, that you may keep it until I rise again. Then he passed away, y'all. And when it got late in the day, they began for everyone to go home. The other two thieves that came and break their legs, in case if they were living and could struggle down off the cross, they couldn't walk away. But they looked at Jesus and saw that he had already passed. So they took the spear to make sure that he was dead, and they stabbed him in his side. And when they stabbed him in his side, out poured blood and water. Water is spirit. Blood is life. It is spewed out, even into the ground. So, later that day, Joseph came to the king, and he came with the one that came to see Jesus by night. Amen. Nicodemus. Nicodemus was encouraged, y'all. Nicodemus got saved. Joseph and Nicodemus came into the king. They said, King, can we have the body? They went in secret because they didn't even want the Jews to know. And Joseph had a tomb already ready for himself that when he passed, where they was going to lay his body. But he said, no, I'm going to put the body of Jesus in there. So they took the body and they wrapped it up in the linen. And they took it to the tomb. And then they laid the body there. And the king said, didn't this Jesus say that he was going to rise in 3 days? He said, I, what I want you to do is take 10 of the strongest soldiers we got. Get a big boulder, and I want you to seal that tomb. And I want you to put two guards there and to stand that it will not be so. Because, see, his disciples could come and steal him.
Yes.
And say that he has risen.
Come on, Pastor.
Amen.
Yes.
So that is what they did. But they didn't know what was going on the inside of the tomb. Jesus didn't lay there for 3 days and then said, I'm going to rise. Oh, when they set off the tomb, Jesus stepped out of that body and descended down into Hades. And the Bible said that he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto me. And he preached the gospel in Hades. He took the keys away from the devil to the pit. He took the sting away from death. He took the victory from the grave. And he took Satan and paraded him down Main Street in Hades. For all the demons in the imps can see that I'm King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And the devil don't have nothing on me. He preached the gospel to those people, and some that had died believed. But some didn't believe. They stayed down there, y'all. I don't understand that out of all the things in the world. Before I can understand that, I can understand how to build a rocket ship. I can understand how to jump to the moon. But I can never understand, how can you be in hell? Somebody preach the gospel to you and you stay and you don't believe. I can't understand that. But some got up. And the Bible said that they were seen of many as they walked the street as a testimony that Jesus set captivity free. That he defeated captivity. That he defeated the devil. And that he reigned. That's what Jesus was doing for 3 days. Not in the tomb, but down in Hades. And then he rose early that morning. See, let me tell you something. When the women came to the tomb, Jesus had already risen.
Mm-hmm.
The body laid there. Huh?
Yes.
But Jesus had risen.
Yes, yes. My God.
He had risen. And that's why he talked about the tomb.
My God.
About the temple. He said the temple will rise in 3 days. But the Jesus part of me. See, he was God. And he was also man. The God part of Jesus never died. It was transferred to the Father. But the body part, the man part, it died. And that was the part that he was telling them that I will raise up in 3 days, was the man part of me. This temple that you see, I will rise it up in 3 days. We almost finished. And Jesus finished the work that he had to do down in Hades. Then what he did, he ascended. Huh? Back up. And then he descended back in the body. Uh-huh. And when he got back into the body, he walked away. We don't know where he went, but he left the tomb. But he left two angels there for a testimony. Jesus told the angels, they're going to have some folks coming here in a little bit. And only thing I need you to do, angels, just tell them when they get here that I has risen. And when the women got there, the angels delivered the message. And they were able to leave. Praise God. Amen. And that's a wonderful and gracious thing that happened in our life. That Jesus died and he rose again. Pray my strength in the Lord.